Nope, that didn't work.
Hey, it's Pete. Welcome to the workshop. This week, I am rebuilding the gearbox on our Carnival Ride restoration project. Going to be replacing the seals and the bearings. Other than that, don't have too much to say about it, so we're just going to get right into it. This pulley uses a tapered hub. To remove it, you take out the two bolts, transfer them to the threaded holes in the hub, and use them to push the pulley off. At least that's how it's supposed to work.
Boy, that's not one to pop. I'm going to use different bolts, because I don't know how old these ones are, and I'm scared they're going to break off. Nope, we're stripping out the hub. Yeah, we might have to come back to that part. Curious just to get a look inside of this, make sure that it's not full of water. Bottom one looks all right. Okay, well, this is a Timpkin 15123, and that is still readily available. So I will get a set of those on order.
This is my blind hole bearing puller. You insert the disc into the bearing, then tighten it up. That causes the disc to expand and pull the bearing out from the inside. I'll leave a link to this, as well as some of the other tools and supplies I used, down in the video description.
15245. It's got some scoring in it. It's a little slimy in the bottom. Looks like we had some water in there. There wasn't nearly as much nastiness in here as there could have been. There it goes. But I need to get this belt pulley off of here, and that's fighting me. That's how it comes out, though. So we're gonna have two more Timken bearings, and then a shaft seal out here. What is holding that on there? I could try it on the press. Nope, that didn't work. Finally. Set by the collars. Only thing I don't have on order is this front seal. We'll figure out what that is and get it on order.
I tried to pull the bearings off the worm gear with my bearing puller, but it was not up to the task. I was going to have to press these off, and that meant I had to make a split collar to help.
So I think we're in pretty good shape here. I've got this pretty well cleaned up with inside and out. I'm going to run a tap down through all these holes just to chase them, make sure they're all clean. And then I think it's time to start putting this back together. My plan here is to get this completely reassembled, and once it's reassembled, then we'll hit it with the paint stripper. But main priority right now is getting it back together. I think I'm going to take this out to my air compressor and blow it off. So I want to start here with our worm gear. I've got two new tapered bearings to put on, and I'm probably going to need to create something to push these on with. You want to make sure as I push them onto the shaft that you're only pushing on the center raceway and not on the basket or the cage with the rollers. Only touching that edge there. So I'm going to see what I've got that might work for that. Took a skim cut on the inside of this bushing because it doesn't matter. We're replacing this anyway, so it doesn't have to be a precision fit. But it does need to be a nice fit on here. This bearing followed by this spacer. And then this bushing, and we'll put the whole thing upside down in the press and just press it right into it. We're free, that's good. Okay, that is tight. I'm assuming this gasket is also a shim. Hopefully when we get this put back together, the spacing and everything will be correct. There was this gasket slash shim on the front, and then there was just an RTV gasket material on the back. Okay, this gasket maker. Gotta take the lid off and pop it. I'm supposed to apply it all around the bolt holes and then install this. Put the bolts finger tight, and then once they're finger tight, we let it sit for an hour. And then once it's set for an hour, then we can go back and snug them up. My hands just aren't strong enough to keep pressure on this to make a continuous bead all the way around. Not my best work. Okay, just finger tight all the way around on these. Right there. These are the bigger bolts. Well, this is going to be our last chance to actually see the inside of this. I had to get you a close-up, huh? An hour has elapsed, so it's time to tighten up our bolts back here. All right, and again. again, just finger tight for an hour. And then we'll come back and crank them down. An hour has gone by, so we can tighten these guys up. Alright, it is time for trimming and stripping.
Hey, if you like projects like this, give it a thumbs up. It really helps the channel out. And while you're at it, click that subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you don't miss a single part of this project.
Our new pulley arrived today, thanks to eBay. Let's see what that looks like. This is supposed to be a new old stock pulley. Certainly looks like it is. Excellent. All right, we're starting to get some crunchiness here. Oh yeah. It literally started raining the second I finished putting the primer on the gearbox.
So we got our new belt pulley and hub, and it's a nice sliding fit on the shaft there. Now I'm not going to tighten up the bolts because this will have to be adjusted to line up with the motor. No sense in causing myself undue aggravation there. Same thing with the chain sprocket. This will have to be adjusted once it's in the ride to line up with the main sprocket on the shaft. We're going to be leaving this in primer gray for now, just like the motor. Both the motor and the gearbox are visible parts of this ride. And since we haven't picked colors yet for the ride, once we do that, everything will get painted the same color. And that'll be done. Only thing left to do on this gearbox is to change this oil seal that's hiding under here. That should be coming in later this week, and that will draw this part of the ride to a close. Next week we'll be tearing into the tower to try to pull that central shaft, so click those links to the left and come along for the ride.